So you can literally block the villagers in their houses if you want to. Like, you can place them in front of that Nook Inc. sign. Hello, everyone, and welcome or welcome back. So today I am going to be doing an updated version on how you can get new plots in Animal Crossing, because the video I did when I first started the channel, you guys really, really loved it. So I'm just going to be doing an updated version because the audio was really bad and things. So let's just get started and let's go. So you get the three first plots when you have built Nook's Cranny, and Tom then comes in the next day with the opening broadcast with a phone call, and he kind of gets interrupted in this broadcast. And then when you go in to resident services, he will say that he has had a phone call from interested parties that want to move into the island, but they want furnished homes instead of tents. He will then ask you to build a bridge, and then you say, what should I do? And you can start to build the houses straight away, or you can wait till the next day to do these houses. It depends how you want to play Animal Crossing, whether you want to just do it day by day, or whether you want to kind of speed run this process and do it completely like on the go. So to kind of make the bridge, you need 4 log stakes, 4 clay pieces and 4 stone. Make the bridge, set it wherever you want to, and then you can grab these 3 plots. You don't need any money for these 3 plots to start off with, but you need a lot of space. So mine are spread out like everywhere because the space you need is ridiculous. Then you walk up to these boxes and it tells you what you need internally and externally. So the external items need to be placed around the sides of these little fences, and then at the front of this fence as well. None of the items can be placed at the back of the fence for some reason, so just keep that in mind. And then the internal items need to be placed in the box. So when you're watching this video, I show you how to do that as well. So what I do is I kind of write everything down of the 3 plots, what all 3 plots need, and then I craft, like I gather all the materials, I craft everything all together, and then I make everything one by one, and then submit everything and place everything around where it needs to go. So that's kind of the gist of it. And then you kind of work through the other bits. I think you get the next lot of plots when all these 3 villagers move in, the resident services is upgraded, you've built the campsite, I think you've built Able Sisters. I'm not quite sure. If you need an in-depth kind of run through, I have done a complete guide to 3 stars, like a speed run, so I'll link that down in the description and it'll be an end screen for you, so you can have a look through that if you want like a complete guide. But yeah, so you then unlock the rest of the plots. These cost 10,000 bells each, so you place those down. You only need 8 villagers to be able to get to 3 stars, so you don't need the full list of villagers, so don't worry about that. And they don't need as much room as these 3 plots. You can place them quite close together. I have no idea why these plots need so much room. It's just ridiculous. It's insane. But yeah, so just keep that in mind, that these plots need so much room and you need to place the items so close to the plots to get them to count, and you cannot place them behind. You have to place them to the sides, and you can place them at the front. So you can literally block the villagers in their houses if you want to. Like, you can place them in front of that Nook ink sign. If you don't like, if you don't want any villagers coming out of their houses, which is quite fun, to be honest. But yes, so you need to make sure all of those items are fulfilled. You have to then go back into that box to make sure all of the check marks are checked off. And it will say all of the interior and all of the exterior are complete, something along those lines. And once you've done that for all three, it will, your character will then turn around and do that like woohoo sign, which means that you have completed it. So hopefully I've answered all your questions. If you have any questions though, leave them in the comments down below and I will answer as many questions as I can. And I do have the previous video where it's a bit more of a let's play version of this, so I will link that down in the description as well, so you can have a look at that. And of course the speedrun version of 3 stars, so you can see that as well. So that is everything for today. I hope you all enjoyed this video. Please don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up and subscribe if you are new so you don't miss out on any new videos. And you can see how this island progresses because I'm so excited for this island. It is called Seacross and it is going to be a seaside town inspired by UK seaside towns. And please don't forget to click on the right to see more Animal Crossing videos. And I hope you all have an amazing rest of the day wherever you are, and I will see you all in the next one. Bye.